Hi guys and welcome back to some more Forza Horizon 4. This round we're jumping online, trying out some online races, and as you can see, our team captain is just overwhelmed with excitement. She's ready for a win, everyone's ready for a win, but I don't think they are ready for the monster that is the Noble M600. Easily my favorite S2 class car in the game, and as you can see, Team Blue already going to work, ramming off a red Aston Martin. And yeah, this is an easy 1-2 for Team Blue, and from then on, pretty straightforward race actually. Until I noticed that one little blob, a little blue blob, was catching up to me at quite a pace. Now, there really is only one car that can catch up to a Noble M600 at that rate, and that is the Ultima. Probably the fastest car in S2 class, but really, really difficult to control. And as you can see, he had some trouble avoiding the traffic. He backed off a little bit, which gave me the opportunity to stay ahead. And well, that was pretty much that victory in the bag. Couple of nice corners, managed to stay ahead of the Ultima until I missed the checkpoints, which I had no idea how I got that checkpoint, but thank you very much, game. Picking up the first victory for Team Blue, a very dominant performance as well, but the game decided to put me into second place for whatever reason. I'll take it. It's a 1-2 for Team Blue, a dominant performance, crushing Team Red once again, and the bad luck seems to continue as I'm leading the pack to the destination of the second race, driving across the countryside until I smashed into the only building around the area. Sad, sad times for the Noble. That would have been an easy victory, but the only thing you can do at this point is the Windows XP shutdown horn. That's the only thing you can do. I mean, still, I won 2 from Team Blue. Another impressive performance, actually. Destroying Team Red once again. So, jumping into the second race, starting towards the back of the grid. So, it's going to be quite a mission to get into first place this time round. And things already start to kick off as two Ultimas clash together. One of them losing their wing, which, let's face it, is not going to impact their downforce. It's Forza. And as usual in an online race, we're already losing a couple of people on the first corner. A couple of people going off track there. Quite far, actually, looking at the minimap. And yeah, this is where things start to unravel a bit. People are going wide. The Centenario is pushing the Ultima into the stone wall, absolutely finishing him. Let's look at that in slow motion. Oh boy, rip. Also a member of Team Blue, so that's not good. It's not looking good for the home team. Saying that, the last red team member clearly outbreaks himself, drives into the woods. So I guess we're not going to see him anytime soon. And yeah, it's a 1-2 again for Team Blue. I'm trying not to crash into the Sonder, just giving a little love bump. And from there on, it's a pretty straightforward race yet again. And Team Blue doing an awesome job securing the first 5 positions of the race. Incredible performance here. Looking at the points, this is just annihilation at this point. And that was also the last event of this championship. Team Blue picking up the overall win. Everyone's super excited. Or not. So now it's time to jump into a different lobby, second event. Dirt racing in S1 class. And if the first person dabs on you and the second person flosses on you, you know you've got a good lobby on your hands featuring some very professional and clean racing. Anyway, we're starting things off with the Ford Focus RS RX, the car of choice for me at least for S1 class dirt racing. Absolute beast, monster of a car. But things quickly start to unravel as a 959 loses control, kisses the wall. Same goes for the Trailcat up ahead, weaving across the track, left, right and center, eventually taking out a Beetle, poor little thing. But yeah, from then on, it's an easy job for Team Blue to claim the first 4 positions of the race. Outstanding performance from the team, and from there on, relatively straightforward race actually, especially for me leading the pack, until someone decided to go for a very ambitious overtake, but decided not to brake for the next corner. Well, as you do. At this point, I could already smell the victory. I could already smell it. But then I decided to take a look back and I found an Audi RS6 in my rearview mirror. Mighty fast car, especially in a straight line. But the brave little Ford Focus RS managing to stay ahead and finishing in first place, picking up another win for Team Blue or not, as the game decides to put me into second place once again. I'm getting mugged off here. What is going on? Let's take a look at that in slow motion. Yeah, I don't think he overtook me on the line. Strange things going on here, strange things. So this is me on the way to our second race location, and as you can tell by the lineup, we've got a Unimog in our lobby. That's always an indicator for some very clean, very professional racing, especially with that sort of livery, no place. And well, the Unimog immediately goes to work, pushing a 959 into the wall, and well, too many dots on the same spot on the minimap, and that can only mean one thing. Chaos, carnage, I crash into the unit, more cars are flying on top of me. I'm just trying to keep on track, trying to keep on the road, trying to avoid the chaos. But it's not really working. I'm still behind the Unimog, a place where you don't want to be if you're fighting for victory, especially if there's a no place livery on the Unimog. That's not a good place to be, so I'm trying, desperately trying to get past the Unimog. It's not really working. And after a couple of nice corners, I spotted my opportunity. Unimog is slowing down and I go for a desperate overtake, which leads to me getting stuck in the wall. So it's not looking good for the home team here. It's looking to be a bit more of a boring race, but fear not, because chaos is about to start once again as we witness the first roll and the second roll of a Fiesta rolling across my screen, rolling across track, managing to avoid the Fiesta, and I found myself back in 8th position. But then the Forza Gods went into action, they listened to my prayers, and the Unimog rolled over. The terror reign of the Unimog was over. We were free to race. A normal race, a happy race. And well, it was a pretty happy race from there on. Managed to overtake the Audi, managed to overtake a couple of other cars as well. Found myself in 4th place, securing a 4th place lockout. All players from Team Blue, amazing performance until I had the biggest noob moment of my career so far. I just fell off the mountain. So that was pretty much that race victory out of the window, but I tried to keep it on track. I tried to keep 4th place, which eventually worked out. And well, once again, absolute dominant performance from the Blue team. I mean, look at the points. People are dabbing, people are jumping, people are cheering. Great time all around on the Blue team, as always. So looking back at the performance and our results with Team Blue, I think it's only fair to give Team Red a chance as well. So I swapped teams, jumped onto Team Red with my red Noble M600. Matching colors for good luck. And yes, things started off relatively easy, relatively calm. No bumping, no crashing, no cars flying across the screen. Relatively civilized. I was surprised. New lobby, new people, until Blue team realized that they are in trouble. So they went for 2 aerial overtakes. I mean, it looks really cool, don't get me wrong, but I'm not sure it's the most efficient way to do things. But hey, who am I to judge? Following a few corners, a couple of people ran wide, managed to end up in 2nd place, which is not too bad that early in the race. And yeah, from there on, relatively straightforward. Managed to catch up to 1st place, who just decided to go straight for whatever reason, but hey, I'll take it. Up into 1st place, last few meters of the race, ending the race in style. 1st place, picking up another win for Team Red this time round. And looking at the results, a relatively balanced lobby, not as dominant as previous races. So yeah, looking forward to some good racing in this lobby. However, the next few races should be relatively boring, relatively straightforward, picking up a couple more wins, but nothing exciting to watch, really. Nothing even rolled over, which was slightly disappointing, but it was enough to pick up an overall win for Team Red. Really proud of my team here, good job. But I think it's time to jump back onto Team Blue for the last 2 races. So for the last few races, I decided to jump into an S2 lobby. Off-road racing this time around, bit of a switch up from the Noble. I decided to jump into my BAC Mono. Now, I haven't tried this car yet online. Don't know if it's going to be competitive or not. Hopefully it will be. Great fun to drive in single player, that's for sure. And yeah, looking at the performance, already made up 4 positions on the first straight before running straight into the wall, sloppy driving there on my behalf. I do apologize for that. Now, luckily for me, people up ahead were still fighting for positions. 2 hatchbacks fighting against the Porsche 911 GT2 RS. Yeah, just force of things. But it was gonna be this corner where 3 people decided to run very deep at the same time, allowing me to slip into 2nd place, just behind the Porsche 911 GT2 RS. Now, this car is really, really fast in S2 class. It took me a couple of moments to catch up, but I eventually managed to get the job done in the BC. Quite a capable car, I have to say. Quite impressive. And once again, a victory for Team Blue. But not as dominant as the previous ones. So after me realizing that the BC is probably not a good car choice for some off-road racing online, I feared that the next race might be a proper off-road race. And well, I was right. It was one of the demo races. And this is pretty much the nightmare matchup of car and track. My BAC is just built for high-speed, flat off-road circuits on dirt, low downforce setup and so on. And this track was the opposite. So my chances of picking up a win were pretty limited. But luckily for me, chaos and carnage were about to unfold once again in an online lobby. What a surprise, especially on that sort of track. Cars were going left, right and center. Cars were drifting, wall tapping, pushing other cars off the track. A Volkswagen Golf reversing across the track for whatever reason. I don't know what was going on there, but that was an interesting move. And from this point on, it was just slow and steady progress, eventually ending up in a 5-way battle for the lead, until A Volkswagen Beetle crossed my path. I pushed the Volkswagen Beetle into the Fiesta. The Fiesta spun out across the track and managed to avoid the Fiesta. Almost slipped into first place. I eventually managed to get the job done and hit the chicken at the same time. One of the more exciting races and definitely an unexpected victory from my side. Once again, incredible performance from the Team Blue, picking up another overall win, 3-0 against Team Red. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you guys found it funny. I hope you guys found it entertaining. And yeah, I'm gonna try and do more online stuff in the future. I've done, I think, way too much offline stuff. And yeah, if you guys liked the video, make sure to drop a like on it. Subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this in the future. And until next time, bye.